So let's think about this. The Super Bowl will look different. It will feel different. We've never seen anything like this. So how do you prepare, Jim, start us off for something that's never been done before?
I think it's okay to say this in the sports universe. We're a little bit numb to it now because we've done a whole season of games without any fans in many cases. So this is not the first time we're going to experience that. And I actually think there's going to be a great atmosphere at this game because we're going to have about as big of an attendance as we've seen. They're going to be these vaccinated healthcare workers and first line responders, which is going to be fantastic. I got to tell you, when it comes to this matchup, I've been around for a few, not only in the NFL, but in other sports too. This is the best. I'm going to sound like a risk of sounding like I'm hyping something. I'm not trying to sell anybody. Everybody knows the game's coming up on Sunday on CBS. This is the best matchup I've ever had a chance to try to document going into the game. Number one.
With that in mind, we're looking here for Tom Brady, if he wins, to have the most Super Bowl titles for a quarterback ever, most NFL championships for a player, period. Also, oldest quarterback to win a Super Bowl. If he gets the win and gets those three accolades, is he the greatest of all time?
I think he's already the greatest of all time. He has six Super Bowls right now. He could have retired with five and he was the greatest. It's like then he went to six. But to go to a new team and to take that team without an offseason and learn a whole new system and go win a Super Bowl in your first year, that's unbelievable. And then on top of it, you only have to go through maybe the most exciting, possibly the best player in the game today right now. So it's like, wow, it'll be very hard for Patrick Mahomes to catch Tom Brady if Tom Brady gets the seven Super Bowls and Patrick's at one.
Tony, you predicted that this would be the matchup back in November. How did you know that? That wasn't a lucky guess on your part.
I watch football enough, and so you study little things, right? And I know these two quarterbacks are just rare and special. And then I'm like, well, Tom, I saw the evolution of their team. I saw the signs where I'm like, well, I can tell you right now, I wouldn't want to play this Buccaneer team after this point. Because you could just see them learning themselves and what they need to be doing more of to win football games, to be efficient. And the Chiefs are just a juggernaut.
Hey, Jim, you've spent time with Patrick Mahomes. How would you describe him?
Well, he's just a fantastic guy. And, you know, here he is 25 years old and he's going to be the youngest ever start back-to-back Super Bowls. But
a baby on the way, Jim, a baby on the way.
Yes, about a month after the Super Bowl, he and Brittany will have their first child. And look, he's just a model guy to have fronting your franchise. And that's why the Chiefs, before the season, extended him to a contract worth $504 million. That's right, $500 million they've invested in him. And I got to tell you, there's going to be some people who say, what is he talking about? As that goes on and quarterback salaries continue to rise, it's going to be proven, I think, in time that he was underpaid because there are going to be more Super Bowls and more championships. He is a five-star quarterback and a 10-star human being.
Do you think Tom Brady is in any way intimidated by the fact that when he looks in the mirror, he's looking at a 43-year-old man, and he's going to go out on that field with a bunch of 20-year-olds and play football?
Tony will attest to this. Tom does not look at age as a number. As a matter of fact, don't think this is the last time we're going to see Tom. And they're already talking about next year they're going to be better than they are this year. Tom's coming back. This is not his retirement game. Even if they win, I firmly believe he's back for more. He's often said he wants to play until he's 45. And actually this week in an interview, he said he doesn't see any reason why he can't adjust that number a little bit and maybe play till closer to 50. So if he wins this, this is the crowning achievement of all the championships to come in and take a new team and a team of strength. No training camp, no preseason game, and lead them to a Super Bowl title. This, to me, would have to be the greatest of all.
We've heard from reliable sources that Tony has a whole pregame song list that he does. So, Tony, all you need to do is just give us a couple notes, and we'll say goodbye.
Well, we do sing before the game. We do love Red Hill Mining Town is a favorite, Born to Run, a couple of good ones. But you have to understand, it's not me who's doing most of the singing. It's really Jim. So if he wants to give you a couple notes, he's going to fire that off for us.
Well, we won't be there in person, but our cardboard cutouts are there in section 115, row K. So if you see us, give us a wave.
By the way, off the big touchdown catch or something to that cardboard cutout of you guys cheering.
We appreciate it.
Yeah, let's see how you guys work in the names Tony, Anthony, and Gayle in your broadcast. We'll be looking.